Hey everybody, welcome back to another video from Breezy Organization. I am actually out of town at the moment, so in the background, everything's gonna look a little bit different. I wanted to get this filmed before I left and time just ran out. Getting back into the homeschooling routine is really throwing me off with my work schedule, but that's why I have a planner and we're gonna get it figured out. So I am on here today to show you, of course, a new release. And then I've also had several comments about how to put your pictures in these little Instax cameras. So if you are, excuse me, they're not cameras, they are little Instax frames. So if you're interested in that, that's gonna be at the end of the video. So first, I'm gonna introduce you to our new products for this week, which I'm really excited about. I will say that my new planners are not getting done as quickly as I would like because I'm working on new products every week, but it's always fun whenever I sit down and try to think of new products for you all. So we're gonna get right into it. We have tons of Christmas and stuff coming later, like Christmas stickers, December stickers and all of that kind of thing. But I figured a lot of people are probably already starting their Christmas list and their Christmas shopping. So with that, I figured we need to go ahead and get a few Christmas things out now so you guys can start enjoying them and making the most of the season. So that is what our release is today. This one's all about keeping track of the gifts you have, where you ordered them from, your order number, tracking number, and if you've received it and if it's gift wrapped. So that one's a really fun one to keep track of everything in one place. We do offer these in a black and gray. Most of it's gray. I think this one actually, I can't remember if I left this black or if I did a dark gray on this one, but I know some people probably won't want the color or they may think the color clashes with the top and the bottom, and so they may not want to do that. I think it's super cheery, so I like it, but I wanted to have both options for you all. So here starts all the rest of the colored ones. This says, and may all your Christmases be white, master to-do list, so you have holiday cards, gifts, decorate, bake, menu, DIY gifts, party, and house guests. These are just things that you would normally do for each of those categories. And then we have a really, really fun bucket list. So this one you can, check off, or you can color in, pick out a color that will match, and I can provide the ones that will match here, but you can mark those off, you can check them off, or you can use a pen, of course, and do that as well. But really, really fun. Bucket list, all the things that pretty much I feel like most people do most of these things on that are on this list. Okay, and then next we have Hustle and Bustle. It's a master gift list. You have all the people that are going to be receiving gifts, the gifts, the store, the price, if you received it, and then if it's wrapped. And then Let It Snow Christmas list. This is the one that comes blank and filled in. So if you want to make your own, you can, or you can do this one, create budget, take holiday photos, bake Christmas cookies, pick out holiday cards, wreath for front door, just some general Christmassy type stuff. And then this one's one of my favorites. It's a favorite Christmas movie list. So you kind of can know whenever you watch these. And you could even add a little circle and like check it off if you want to check it off each year that you have watched one of these movies. But it allows you to put your movie in here. You do have to crop sometimes the file, and I'll show you that. It's going to be basically the same way that you use the Instax frames. But really, really fun way to use your favorite Christmas movies. And then next we have a fa-la-la-la bucket list. So basically the vision for this is for you to go ahead and fill all of these in with bucket list ideas for you, you and your family. And then as you do them during the December, you can put in pictures of the event or you doing them. And I think it's so fun and it's gonna be a great memory page to have in your planner. And then next we have a Christmas list. So this is the one that was black that I was showing you at the beginning. It says making the list, checking it twice. And then basically you have a spot to put in a picture and a name, and then age, budget, size, and likes. So this gives you kind of a general idea of what you would need to buy this individual. And then over here you have a wish list where you can just put in stuff from Pinterest or Target or wherever you're shopping, Amazon. Go ahead and put in all of the ideas that you have in the wish list or all the wish list items that she may have. And then once you buy said item, you can put it over here on your how many ever presents you get that particular individual. So it's a lot of fun. And what's really cool about this is Amazon, Target, and all those places, if you just right click on the product, you can save the photo to your device or your computer, and you can put them in there. And they normally have a white background. So these already have a white background. Now, if you want to trim them down, you hit that image icon, click it again, and hit crop. And then you can either rectangle, crop it down, or you can freehand and actually draw around for it to cut out certain areas. So that's how I did that with the white background to be able to put that in there. really fun. I think it looks really neat. And then the next one is a Christmas savings page. So this one turned out really cute. So you can put the amount that you're trying to save for here, and then you're just going to hit the highlighter tool and pick a color, and then simply just fill it in. Now, I will say that if you pick up on it, you're going to get like a double line, so you almost need to not pick up on it. You can go back and forth as many times as you need, and you can actually, a little trick with this is you can actually get out of the lines if you're not a very good colorer. You can color this in, but say I got out of the lines really bad over here. If you hit the eraser tool, it will just erase little bits at a time, and you can pretty much save your image like that to where it looks like that you did it, you know, really good. I did a different tone here in the middle, but you can just color those in, and I thought it was a really fun different way to use the savings aspect rather than just the savings jar. So that's a look at that. And then we have the party planner. So this is all about the food, appetizers, main dish, side dish, dessert, and drinks. You have your decorations, the details, entertainment, and to-do. If you are a Christmas party person, this is the page for you. You're gonna love it. It's gonna keep you all organized. And then the next page is a naughty or nice Christmas list. So this one's if you want to plan for a bunch of people. So you have a spot to put the person's name, the budget, and then what are gift ideas that she may like or he may like. And then over here, it just says favorite sizes, age. So you can just jot down any information that you have about that, so you make sure you get them the right size. This one's set up just like our bucket list. Say you didn't want to use a bucket list or you want to use both of these inserts, totally fine. You have merry and bright memories, and then it says the same thing down here. This is just for you to collect some Christmas pictures, and you have a cute little Christmas page that you can put. You could even put this if you didn't want a separate tab section. This could just be thrown into your vision board page for December. That would be super fun too. Okay, another really fun one, and I think our last one in the inserts collection, and that is the Christmas countdown. Now, no, I did not draw these amazing, or color these amazing things in. That was done by my 3-year-old and my 6-year-old, but they had a lot of fun with this page. I think this one's gonna be really fun too. So it's a Christmas countdown, and it has 25 squares. So on the 1st of December, you get to color your first little ornament. And then on the 2nd, you get to color the little mittens, and so on, all the way down to the last day of Christmas. So kind of like the advent calendars. I thought it was really fun to do a digital planning type spin on that. So, you know, yours will come blank like this. And I will show you another trick with that. Okay, so they're gonna come blank like that. So you can either pick a color over here, make it thicker, and then you can start coloring these in like this if you're really, really good at coloring, because if you go over that black line, it's going to disappear. Or if you're not so good at coloring, you can always hit that highlighter tool, and you can pick a dark green, and then you can color over, which always remember the highlighter tool is gonna be kind of a tiny bit transparent, so it's not gonna be like a vibrant color. So you may want to pick a little bit different color for this. It's maybe just too dungy. But if you go over the lines still show. So if you hit the highlighter tool, you don't have to worry about being so perfect and in line with everything. So that's another little trick. But I really like how that page turned out. And of course, my kiddos, they were super excited about it. And they keep asking if they can color on the iPad on the new thing. So really, really fun. That is a look at that, and these all also come in the grayscale as well. So if you're not into the color, that's totally fine. And how you are going to insert these. So let me take one of these out so I can show you that. So we're going to pull up files. I highly recommend you going to our beginner, our start digital planning. I'll try to link it down below. We have a getting started with digital planning video, and it walks through all the steps, how to purchase, what kind of planners we have, how to download them, put them on your device, how to start using them, how to save them, all of the details. So this is what I like to do with split screen whenever I'm adding over inserts or widgets. Sometimes I do it like this. And so the inserts are going to work the same way as widgets. So you're just going to drag one and pull it over here, and then you can use this little blue double arrow thing down here to size it and put it where you would like it, and then you're going to click off. So size it however you like there. And that's as easy as it gets with putting these in. And like I said, it's not bad pixelated. I don't know if you can tell that zoomed in a lot. So, I mean, it's definitely not bad, but I do want you all to know that if you zoom way, way, way in, the text sometimes will look a tiny bit pixelated. Okay, next we have our widgets. A lot of these will transfer over the same type of things that I have for the inserts. Me personally, I like a couple of the big inserts and then I like several of these little widgets. So I'm going to be using both, but I wanted to have both options for everybody, especially if you're not totally into the color, but you don't like the grayscale either of the inserts, these will be perfect for you. You know, just whatever you need. I tried to make it both options available for you. So we have a Christmas activities one. So that one's going to go down here in one of these spots, and it just says Christmas activities, merry and bright, and you can just write a list of activities that you want to do and then keep checking those off. This one is a Christmas bucket list, so this is really fun. You can put a picture over here to the side and then write in what you want to do and then check it off once you've done it. And then this is a Christmas expenses. We all know that Christmas can get very expensive. And so we have Christmas expenses, the description, and then the amount. And then you can put your total down there at the bottom. And then this is a really fun one if you want to keep track of like multiple family members at one time, what you're getting them for Christmas. So it says gift list, holly jolly Christmas. You can put their names in these black spots and then your gift ideas there. So that allows you to have six different people on one widget. Of what you're thinking about buying there. And then over here on the next one, we have a Christmas party planner. So again, we have a really fun one where you could put your inspiration here of different, like say you're doing an ugly sweater Christmas party, you could put inspiration in here, then what you need to buy and a checklist of what needs to be done. And then we have the savings jar. So Christmas savings jar, you can put your goal in there and then fill up your jar just like we normally do. And then I did go ahead and do the Christmas tree as well because I thought it was really, really cute. And you can just use this the same exact way. You can put your amounts over here on the side and then fill them up. You can even alternate and put an amount here and an amount here, you know, and as you fill it up to that amount. So really fun. I love the Christmas tree idea for something different. And then we have Christmas shopping. It says hustle and bustle. Again, just a checklist there. And then we have Christmas theme. So this one, I kind of like matching my tree and like my wrapping paper and stuff all together as the years go by. Sometimes I change it. Asia do change it. I think I'm going to keep it the same as I did last year for the most part. But so I did one for Christmas theme. It's basically kind of like Christmas decor. But yet I don't know that I'll do my decor on this one. It was just mainly for like the wrapping paper and the Christmas tree. So I have an inspiration spot and a to buy spot, for that. And then I have a Christmas wish list. So this one is really fun. They're white squares. That way you can add stuff from Amazon or any of those with a white background and you don't have to hardly do any cropping to it. So this can be a Christmas wish list for your whole family, or it could just be for you. I could probably definitely fill up these squares just for me. But you could have one for each member of the family, you know, whatever you needed to do for that. Really, really fun one. I love those little squares. This is a play off of the Christmas countdown like we did for the coloring in for the inserts. So you have 24 days on this one. So this one, basically you would mark off or you could color in or you could highlight it. And so that will tell you how many days you have left until Christmas. And then down here it says Merry Christmas. So that one's a fun one to use on the month of December. And then the last one we have is stocking shopping. And I thought that was really funny whenever I typed it in. It's probably not as funny as what I thought it was, but anyways, it says stocking shopping and then it says jingle bells. I don't know about you, but sometimes it's very hard for me to come up with stocking stuffer ideas. So I like to look at Pinterest first or look online, Google. Sometimes you can get like 100 idea list and then I'll go from that list and just write some things down. And now that I have the iPad mini 6, which I can pull it up on my phone too, but I have my iPad mini 6 with me all the time and I can just throw it up and see exactly what I wrote in if I happen to be at a store that might have some stuff for the stocking. That is a look at both of those. You'll find them linked down below along with this planner and our other life planners. Don't forget, we have a bunch of new life planners releasing next month. I'm going to show you exactly how you can add in those pictures inside your Instax cameras. Okay, so there's two ways to use Instax frames. Now, the easiest way to use Instax frames is, of course, to add whatever your bottom layer is going to be first, because whatever you add onto the page first is what's going to be on the bottom layer. So it's going to be behind the Instax after you add that in. But if you pre-plan pages like I do a lot, you will already have your insects image on there, and then you have to add in your picture. So I'm going to show you what you're going to do if you've already done that. Okay, so once you have your picture selected, what I like to do is go over here on top of the insects camera, or you want to go over here on top of your insects, and I like to zoom in and then just kind of fill up, depending on the picture. I want this picture to be a little bit bigger, so I'm going to put it right there. And then I click on it again and hit crop. And then I'm just going to bring this down and bring it over a little bit. And then what I want to do is just make sure that this picture is not going to show outside of this orange frame. I'm going to bring in the bottom just a little bit. Okay, so I can see this rust color frame all the way around it. Okay, so now I'm going to go on and I'm going to do the next one. And this may seem a little bit tedious at the beginning, but you kind of get an eye for how big it is, and it's not hard once you get used to it. So you're going to bring these in, and that's about right. Okay, and then we're going to do this one. So let's bring it in. About right here. And then I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to bring this side in. Okay, that's gonna work. I'm gonna actually change these though, because I don't want that green and yellow to clash. Okay, so that's what I wanna do. So now I'm gonna hit the lasso tool, and then I'm gonna have to change this one, but I'm gonna try to just select these frames. I'm gonna hit copy, and then I'm gonna hit again, and I'm gonna hit delete. So they're gonna be sized and exactly in the right place. I'm gonna hit paste. So they're going to be the right size, and then I'm just going to paste them right on top, and they should fit exactly. And that's how you can use the insects frame. You can use it to where the frame is just sitting on top of the insects too. That is totally doable, but I did design them to where it was transparent in the middle, so you could have those perfect edge photos if you want to use it that way. I hope that helps a little bit better. Like I said, sometimes it's easier if you just go ahead and put the pictures in first and then just put the insects inserted in after. You know, it doesn't matter, like if I go and add another picture in, it doesn't matter how many times I try to make this one go underneath that frame, it's not going to happen. Even if I click on this frame and see how it goes on top of this picture, whenever I click off of it, it's going to go back underneath because it was added to the page before I added the picture. So it works in layers. So you cannot insert anything into a page. I know a backspace out of this. So you cannot insert anything on a page that you want to be underneath something else. Like, you have to put it in that layer format. So that it has to be picture, and then insert your Instax, and then insert your sticker, and so on and so forth. And say, like me, I had the Instax images in there first, and then I put my picture. Okay, so I sized my pictures how I needed to be, and then I copied and deleted those Instax frames, and then repasted them in to where they were the top layer. Hopefully that makes sense. They're really fun to use, and it doesn't take long to get the hang of it. Thank you so much for joining us today, and let me know if you have any questions down below. I do have a video on digital planning on the new iPad Mini 6. It was supposed to have uploaded, and somehow something went wrong and it didn't upload. So I do have that. That's going to be uploaded for you guys shortly, maybe before this video is released. That one may be already on the channel. If not, it's going to be this week coming. So I hope you guys enjoy that. Thanks so much for coming around and watching me every single week. I really, really appreciate it. I hope you guys learned something and that these products are super beneficial to you guys. I will catch you on the next one, and happy planning.